Hey mamas, newborn babies bring a lot of new things to think about and take care of, and it can sometimes be overwhelming trying to remember how to do all of the things. So in this video, which is a part of a whole playlist of videos about infant care during the first year of life, is going to take away some of the overwhelm about caring for baby's umbilical cord. I am Bridget and I'm a childbirth educator and birth doula, and I love supporting and encouraging mamas in the reality that they are built to grow, birth, nourish, and nurture their babies. If you are new to this YouTube community and want to be a part of it, all you have to do is subscribe and hit the little bell so you don't miss any future videos. Every single parent of a newborn is going to have to deal with umbilical cord care because every baby is born with an umbilical cord. By the end of this video, you're going to know how to take care of your baby's umbilical cord before it falls off, signs of infection to look for, and what to do if the umbilical stump becomes infected. So the umbilical cord is what connected your baby to the placenta throughout pregnancy, and after birth, the cord is clamped and then cut to separate baby from their placenta, which they no longer need in the outside world. Now, if you're watching this while you're pregnant, you should check out this video that's linked up here about delayed cord clamping after birth and its immense benefits for baby. But for the baby that's already been born, the clamp will remain on the umbilical cord stump until the stump is completely dry. By the time that you leave the hospital, the cord will already be starting to dry up and wither, and the clamp might be removed then. But it's likely that if it's not removed then, it will be removed in the days following when you go to meet with your baby's pediatrician. When it comes to belly button care for your newborn, it's typically best to leave it well alone. So instead of messing with the clamp, it's usually best to let your care provider remove it for you. The umbilical cord usually will fall off, usually between 1 to 2 weeks after birth on its own. Remember, it's best if it's left alone to heal naturally. You don't want to pick it and try to tug on it to get it to fall off faster, even if it's just hanging on by a thread. So to help it heal and fall off naturally and to avoid any friction or snags on it that can pull at the drying cord, there are a few things that you can do. So when you're changing your baby's diaper, fold the top front part of the diaper inside itself so that it fits under the baby's belly button. Some newborn diapers actually make them like that already to begin with so that the front is lower and it fits snugly under the belly button and the diaper isn't irritating that belly button site when it sits on top of it. Putting your baby in loose enough clothing is also helpful. So for example, you obviously don't want to put pants on them where the band sits right on top of the umbilical cord. If you are going to have them wear pants, just make sure it's under that belly button cord, just like the diaper is. Now, just because you want to dress them loosely doesn't mean that you have to dress them in super baggy clothes or anything, and swaddling is still fine as well, but you just don't want anything that is going to compress their belly button. The next thing to hold off on until the umbilical cord falls off are baths. You really don't want to submerge your baby's body underwater until after their cord has completely fallen off and healed. Sponge baths are perfectly fine for the first couple weeks of life, where you are just using a washcloth or a soft sponge to clean baby's face, their neck rolls, and then their diaper area. Those are the most important places to keep clean because those are the areas that will get dirty most often. And if you're keeping those areas clean regularly throughout the day, then a bath might not even be necessary at all. If your baby has a lot of hair and you do need to wash it because they are getting spit up in it and it's getting in their hair, or you drop mustard on their head while you're eating, you can simply swaddle them, get their hair wet, lather in some non-toxic shampoo, which I have linked down below, because you really want to be using products on your baby that are safe and aren't going to be putting plastics, chemicals, or synthetic fragrances into their body. And then you're going to turn the tap water on in the sink, check the temperature of the water, and then run their hair under the water. Babies typically really enjoy this because the warmth on their head is super relaxing and comforting to them, and this avoids putting them into the tub before their cord stump has fallen off. So cord care is pretty straightforward. Leave it alone as much as possible. So you don't need to use alcohol to clean the area, but if you do notice the area is getting dirty, like they've pooped and it's gone up their tummy, tummy, which probably will happen at some point, you can take a wet cotton swab or a cotton pad, both of which I have linked down below if you don't have any at your house, and then clean around the area. You just want to make sure if the cord has gotten wet that you dry it off as well. You really want to keep the skin around the umbilical cord as dry as possible to help it fall off. I don't recommend using a cotton ball to dry off the skin because it can leave little bits of the cotton on the stump. So instead, just use a dry washcloth, which I've linked down below, and then pat the area as dry as you can. If the umbilical cord falls off and starts bleeding a little bit, you want to take sterile gauze, preferably, but if you don't have that, something that's clean, to apply just enough pressure to that belly button to help stop the bleeding. You should call your baby's pediatrician about that and check in about following up with them, and you want to call them right away if the applied pressure with the gauze doesn't stop the bleeding. Now, sometimes the umbilical cord gets infected, and you'll notice an infection if the belly button skin turns red and irritated or starts oozing yellow or foul-smelling discharge. If your baby gets a fever or their appetite changes and they start eating less, take a look at their belly button site and see if you see any of those signs, and then notify the pediatrician as soon as possible so that you can get your baby the care that they need. This is pretty uncommon, and if you leave the umbilical cord pretty well alone, as I've been saying, this is pretty unlikely to happen. But if it does, your doctor might prescribe antibiotics to your baby, or they might just clean and cauterize the cord using silver nitrate on a cotton swab, which helps dry up the tissue and allows for new skin to grow over it and then to heal it. So as I said, that's rare that needs to happen, but if it does become infected, the treatment is pretty simple. So basically, to wrap up this video, umbilical cord is pretty simple. Try not to mess with it. Babies' bodies, as small as they are, do a pretty good job of knowing what to do when it comes to things like this. I hope this video has given you the answers that you need to care for your newborn, even in the small ways, because when you are confident in the small things, you are more confident to tackle the big things as well. So thanks for being with me in this video, and I'll see you in the next one.